Hi mommies and daddies, welcome back to Momcom India. In this video, I am going to cover a topic which is very important for any woman who is pregnant or who's delivered a baby and is on the breastfeeding journey. This is about breast care, where I'll be talking about three key problems: sore nipples, breast engorgement, and breast sagging. This is a two-part video. Part one is this, where I'll be talking about nipple problems in detail, and part two is going to be breast engorgement and breast sagging, which will come out on our channel on Saturday. So make sure that you watch both the parts to get a complete picture about this topic. अगर आप एक हिंदी व्यूअर हैं तो इस टॉपिक का हिंदी वर्जन हम अपने चैनल पे ऑलरेडी कल पोस्ट कर चुके हैं. नाउ लॉट ऑफ वुमेन फील दैट ब्रेस्ट केयर एक्चुअली बिगिंस पोस्ट यू डिलीवर अ बेबी एंड यू स्टार्ट ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग, बट दैट्स नॉट हाउ इट इज. इट एक्चुअली बिगिंस वाइल यू आर प्रेग्नेंट. नॉर्मली योर गायनोकोलॉजिस्ट एज पार्ट ऑफ योर रूटीन चेकअप्स विल ऑल्सो चेक योर ब्रेस्ट टू सी इफ देर आर एनी लम्स और इफ देर इज एनी इन्फेक्शन और इफ द निप्पल इज प्रॉपर. इफ दैट मीन्स दैट निप्पल इज नॉट इन्वर्टेड और फ्लैट, विच विल मीन दैट यू be able to feed your baby properly. So all of these things will be ruled out while you're pregnant. If your gynecologist has not done that already, make sure you book an appointment and you get all of these things ruled out. That's part one. Now part two is that post you have your baby and you are exclusively breastfeeding, there are certain problems that you're going to have, and you need to know what are the solutions that you need to take to prevent those problems or to remediate those problems. First problem is going to be sore nipples or cracked nipples, dry nipples, or bleeding in nipples. Now this happens to certain ladies or this does not happen to certain ladies. It totally depends. The second problem can be breast engorgement, where your breast becomes extremely full, it pains, it becomes hard, it can become red. And third is breast sagging. So second and third point will be covered in the next video. Let's talk about the first one in detail. Now, why does nipple problem happen? Why do nipples start to bleed? Why do they become cracked? Why do they become painful? Number one reason is improper hygiene. Now what happens is that initially we make so much breast milk that at times the breast start to leak. Because of that leakage, there is wetness in the nipple area, because of which there can be infection and because of which you can have problems like sore nipples or extreme dryness. Second problem could be that after your baby feeds, you did not clean that area properly, because of which either the breast milk stays there or maybe your baby has some kind of a tongue tie or any mouth infection in the initial days, because of which there is an infection that's passed on. So in both these cases, because of improper hygiene, you could have a sore nipple or a nipple related problem. Now, what is it that you can do in this case? The answer is very simple. The answer is practicing proper hygiene regularly. I would again emphasize regularly. Number one, after every feed, make sure you wash that entire area just with plain water. Don't use any soap, because you need to ensure that the natural moisture of the skin of the breast stays intact. After you wash it, let it air dry. If you don't have time, then dab it very gently with a clean washcloth. Once you have done that, apply a nice ointment or a nice nip care cream, which will ensure that your soreness or your nipple related problems do not happen in the first place. You know, it's like when you have to take care of your baby's diaper rash, when you clean the area, you apply a good ointment or you apply some nice cream to ensure that there's no rash. It's just like that for our nipples also. So here the product that I will recommend is Mama Earth's Nipple Butter Cream, specially designed for sore and cracked nipples. Its key ingredients are shea butter, coconut oil, and calendula oil. Individually also, all these three ingredients are known to treat dry, cracked skin immediately. Also, most importantly, it's 100% natural. It has no preservatives in it. It is fragrance free, which is very important so that the baby does not get distracted or does not leave the breast. And most importantly, it is safe, just in case also it is ingested by the baby. Although you should always clean your breast before feeding the baby, but just in case that happens, even then it is absolutely safe. This is a 50 ml bottle and the MRP is 500 rupees with the expiry of 2 years, available for 500 rupees. But if you buy it from Mama Earth website, you can get an additional 20% discount by using the coupon code MOMCOM20, and this will then cost you 400 rupees. So this coupon code is specially for MOMCOM viewers. Just in case you want to buy it from there, you can get that additional discount. Mama Earth is Asia's first Made Safe certified brand, so you can definitely trust it for yourself and for your babies. And just in case you're somebody who believes in 100% natural or home remedies only, then two tips I have for you is that post you clean your breast with water and air dry it, then apply a little bit of breast milk or pure ghee on that area, leave it for half an hour, then clean it properly, and then you are good to go. So that's also something that you can do. So this was improper hygiene and the solutions. Now let's talk about the second big problem, which is feeding. Now there are a couple of problems that happen under feeding. Number one is latching issues. What happens is that since babies don't understand the process of breastfeeding, especially initially, they would normally go ahead and suck the nipple only, while they should be sucking the nipple and the areola behind them, the dark brown part. But they don't do that, and when they only suck the nipple, A, they don't get the milk because the milk glands are actually in the areola, which is how they stimulate, and B, because of constantly sucking the nipple and not getting the milk, the baby also gets irritated and sucks even hard, and the nipple gets damaged. So to this problem, the solution is that ideally, when you're in the hospital post your delivery for 2 to 3 days, do as much feeding in front of the doctor as much as you can, so that you and your baby both can learn the right process of breastfeeding. That's number one. Number two is you can watch a lot of videos on YouTube and learn how to do the right latching or the right feeding. We will link a couple of videos also in the description box below just for your reference. Number three, if you still don't understand, is consult a lactation consultant and get some help. The second problem under feeding is the feeding position. Now a lot of times, you know, because we are very tired, we end up feeding the baby while lying down, and the baby is so sleepy that while taking the feed only, the baby sleeps and the nipple remains in the baby's mouth. Now suddenly when you try to take the nipple out, the baby may just bite the nipple or you know, may suck the nipple hard because the baby doesn't know what's happening, and it can cause damage. So the best way of removing that latch is that place your finger between the baby's mouth and the nipple and gently remove that latch, because of which the problem will not happen. The third problem under feeding is vigorous feeding. Now what happens is that if there's too much gap between feeding or the baby did not get the last feed properly, the baby becomes extremely hungry and will vigorously latch onto the breast to get milk, and that can be very hard on your nipple because the baby will suck hard. So the solution to that is that maintain a 2 to 3 hour gap. Small frequent feeds are the best way to go when it comes to breastfeeding and avoiding nipple issues. And the last problem could be low supply. You know, at times while breastfeeding, we don't know that our supply is going down. There is some milk that comes initially, and after that the milk supply goes down, but the baby continues to suck milk, because of which the nipples get really, really tender, and then they become sore or dry or cracked. The best way to know that you still have your supply maintained well is pump a little bit of milk using your hand pre and post feeding. So pre-feeding, pump a little bit of milk so that the supply can start, and even post-feeding, pump a little bit of milk to check whether the milk supply is still intact or not. That way you can avoid the problems of low supply, because of which the baby will keep sucking hard on the nipple. Also, for maintaining good breast milk supply, there's a separate video that I have done, so you can go ahead and check some remedies that you can do to ensure that you have a good breast milk supply. So these were the problems and the solutions related to feeding. The third problem could be improper pumping. So if you're a working mother especially, or if you're somebody who's using a breast pump to bottle feed your baby, so ensure that you're using the pump in the right manner. At times, again, if only the nipple is going in the pump and you continue to pump manually or electric pump, then again the nipple will become sore. ensure that the areola and the nipple both are getting into the pump. So the size of the pump should be appropriate, and also the position of the pump should be fine when you're doing the pumping. So that's important. Lastly, soreness can also happen due to heavy breasts. So since we make a lot of milk, especially in the initial days, our breasts can be really, really full, and the nipple area can also get really full, because of which the nipple can actually inflammate or can become sore. So the best way to treat that is that whenever that happens and you will feel that your breasts are becoming hard, do a manual express. So when you do that, you will let down some milk supply, and because of which the breast will feel better, the nipple will feel better, and you'll also feel relaxed. So these were the key problems and the solutions which will help you avoid nipple related problems throughout your breastfeeding journey and make it a smooth journey for you. One question that's generally asked is that should we continue to feed the baby when the nipples are sore? Because you know, sore nipples can be really, really painful. Women can actually cry when that happens. The answer to that is that if you're bleeding, then don't, because you don't want the blood to get into the baby's mouth. If you're bleeding, then you should immediately see a doctor. But if you're not bleeding, then slowly you can continue to do that. Preference will be that start from the breast where you do not have a sore nipple, so that the baby's stomach gets full to a great extent, and then move on to the breast where the nipple is sore, because by that time the baby's stomach is full and the baby will be gentle on the breast or the nipple and will not suck that hard. But if you're facing a problem, it's better to consult your gynecologist and get a solution to it, because you don't want to put a hard stop on the feeding process, because that's the only nutrition that your baby has, especially in the first 6 months. Lastly, I'll say if you maintain proper hygiene and proper feeding intervals can really help you have a smooth breastfeeding journey and can avoid breast related problems to a great extent. So please go ahead and definitely give a try to Mama Earth Nipple Butter Cream. This can really do wonders in your breastfeeding journey. This cream, apart from individually, is available in a mama hamper also. So just in case as a mother you want to pamper yourself, you can go ahead and use that hamper that has a C3 face mask for healthy glowing skin for the mothers, and that also has an under eye cream. Considering we moms spend so much time just waking up or staying up late in the night or not sleeping, we can get those dark circles. So you can go ahead and get a look at that also. If you have any more questions, then put your question in the comment section below, and do watch the next video for the other two problems related to breast care. Thank you so much for watching MomCom India. Bye bye.